Coming up, a daring humpback whale rescue mission in Mexico. Welcome to Jonathan Bird's Blue World.
Humpback whales are among the largest animals on Earth. They roam all the oceans, making massive migrations between warm tropical water, where they give birth to their young, and colder waters where they feed on more abundant food like small fish and krill. But while the humpback is a mighty creature, it is not invincible. Humpbacks are regularly injured and killed due to human causes such as pollution, ship strikes, and the most deadly, fishing gear entanglement. It's September 2017. The Blue World team is boarding the liveaboard dive boat Sea Escape in Ensenada, Mexico, for an adventure filming great white sharks at Guadalupe Island, 150 miles offshore. We depart and begin a 12-hour run to the island. Within a few hours, divers Kitty Edwards and Jamie Matheson have spotted something unusual.
So we were up on the top deck talking about marine debris and ocean conservation and looking for whales. And
all of a sudden I look out and I see an orange buoy. I saw a splash around it and some gray. It looked like it could have been a whale. Told the rest of the group and we looked out at it for a minute and lo and behold, it was actually a whale that was entangled in some marine debris.
To get a closer look, I run to the top deck with my camera. Zooming in, I can clearly see a whale pulling a buoy.
Looks like he's dragging a long line or something with a buoy, and then there's a bunch of kelp on it.
Does he come up to breathe?
Yeah.
To get a better view of the situation, we launch our drone.
Lose it. Don't lose it.
From a high vantage point, we can see that the whale is dragging a lot of rope, two buoys, and a bunch of kelp that has been snared on the buoy. There's no way this whale will be able to feed dragging this much stuff. It will surely die a slow death of starvation. Our dive master, Benjamin Fernandez Olivari, has a daring plan. He calls another nearby dive boat, the Solmar 5, for assistance, and they send over some of their crew in a small, fast boat called a panga. They pick up Benjamin and two other crew members and set out for the whale. When they get close, Benjamin jumps into the water with a knife to cut the rope. The whale doesn't understand what's happening and speeds up. Things are quickly getting dangerous.
It was a little bit scary, man, to be honest with you, because at first I started climbing on the line and she got scared. She started pulling on me.
Like a Nantucket sleigh ride from the whaling days, Benjamin is hanging on while the whale pulls him through the water.
I was holding on to the line of the buoy, and as the whale pulls forward, what happens is that you get taken underneath the surface. So I really couldn't breathe many times, so I was like, okay, right now I have to pull down the line and go all the way down to cut it, because if I just hold on to this, what's gonna happen is that I'm not gonna be able to breathe. So if I can't breathe, I'm gonna have to let go. So I rode it for a while like that, until I noticed that there was nothing I could do because her tail was right underneath me. So so I didn't want it to be in the way of the tail if she got scared, because it's dangerous. She dragged me for a while until I noticed that she was not gonna stop and I was not gonna reach the place I had to, so I let it go. We just decided to follow the whale side by side with the panga for a while so we could see if she was gonna let us do it, if she was not gonna let us do it, see what's what, you know? When you're in the water with an animal that size, in a panga, with a bunch of people, you need to be careful, you know? You don't wanna hurt anybody.
The fact of the matter is that people have been killed attempting to rescue whales from entanglement. These animals are huge and powerful and do not always understand what is happening. But in spite of the danger and frustration, the team tries again. And soon they succeed in cutting the rope, freeing the whale from the buoys and kelp, slowing it down.
I've seen this online a million times. And I always think, what would I do if I get caught in a situation like that? And you never know, man, because everybody always says, oh, I would have done that, I wouldn't have done this. And you never know what you're gonna do until you get put in a situation like that, in a limit situation. So gladly, everything went well, man. We reacted the way we were supposed to.
With the whale safe and free, the crew of the Salmar 5 returned to their boat as heroes. And this marine debris will never endanger another whale. We're a few hours late arriving at Guadalupe to dive with the sharks, but everyone on our boat agrees that it was for a great cause, saving the life of a humpback whale.